Hey guys, what's up? Zijin Chen here, and this is the unboxing of the Chuwi Hi10. I'm very glad to have finally gotten this tablet. I'm currently still waiting for my keyboard, so it's just the tablet for now. So let's open the box up and see what we got. Actually, first, let's talk about the box itself. Chuwi has long gone with the recycled cardboard box feel, and yeah, this is the exact same. Yeah, so let's open it up and see what we got inside. Okay. So first we got the tablet. Let's put that aside first and see what else we have in the box. Okay. So we have a couple of manuals here. I don't really look at the manuals. They're kind of useless for nowadays, so. But I guess you still need them in the box. And here we got, the charger. Yeah. So here we got the charger, and this is the charger that is for Asia. And I'm in North America, but yeah. I have a ton of chargers, so that doesn't really make a difference. And here you have a USB cable as well. USB 2, by the way, not USB 3. Okay, so accessories are pretty minimal, but it's what I expected. Let's put the box aside and open up the tablet. So, very poorly applied screen protector. Let's take that off. Okay. So, this is the Chuwi Hi10. The update to the Chuwi Vi10, and the Vi10 is a glass tablet. This one's plastic, and it feels a little thicker than the Chuwi Vi10, but I have a feeling it's actually thinner. It might be because of the plastic itself or something like that. But yeah, I actually kind of like this plastic better than the glass, just because I don't have to be as afraid of of putting it down on the ground like this. Whereas with the Chuwi Vi10, which I have right here, actually. So, see, this is the Chuwi Vi10. Oh, actually, the Chuwi Vi10 is way bigger than the Hi10. Just a good thing, too. But like this, I'm afraid of putting it down just because both sides are glass. So, yeah. Glass looks a lot nicer, but it's a lot more fragile, that's the problem. See, and see the massive amount of scratches on this tablet already. And I don't use this, it's my sister, so. Whoa, that was close. But yeah, so let's go back to the Chuwi Hi10. Okay. Yeah, so front of the tablet's pretty simple. You have your screen, you have pretty small bezels for a screen with a keyboard, which I'm pretty pleased with. And let's actually see. I'm gonna turn on the focus. So you can see this. Nope. Let's turn on manual focus. Okay, so these are the power buttons over here. Over here you have got nothing. Over here you have the keyboard dock, and here are all the ports. Let me focus that for you again. Should be good. So you have your headphone jack, you have your HDMI, USB, micro USB, and USB 3, and your micro SD card slot. So again, I'm very much like that they have two USB ports, and I'm especially glad that they have one USB 3 port, so I'm very pleased with that. So let's go back to the tablet itself. Let's actually turn it on and see what we have. I'm gonna turn on, there we go, let it focus. Let's turn it on. There we go. Okay, now that you're focused on the tablet. Okay, so we're waiting for it to turn on. Chuwi logo, their jingle thing. Okay. Let's see. So yeah, so Here we got the tablet. Let's see. So yeah, I actually did an unboxing already of this, but I had to redo it just because the camera wasn't focusing properly. So yeah, let's see if you can see that properly. I'm paranoid now that you can't see it properly. Okay, now let's have a look at the Chuwi Hi10. So let's see. What do we have here? Oh, it's not in tablet mode, actually. I don't know why it's not swiping left. Might be because I'm in desktop mode. Let's see. Or maybe it's still loading? Nothing's responding. I don't know why. Because when I first got this tablet, it was super, super smooth. And that was like 5 minutes ago. So, I don't know what's happening here. You know what? I'm gonna plug in my Bluetooth mouse and see what we got here. Okay. There we go. Yeah, I don't know why nothing's happening. Must be in. Can't even swipe. I don't know why. It's just so weird. I want to turn on tablet mode because it's open action center. See if that works. This is really weird. Cortana works. Tablet mode. Tablet mode. There we go. Everything just suddenly turned on at once. Okay, so let's actually go back to... I do not want to use Bing. Let's actually go back to using the touch screen for a while. Okay. So let's turn on tablet mode because it's... way better for a tablet. Okay. And yeah, let's see. So swiping from the left. But yeah, so now it's super responsive. It was still loading, I guess. So yeah, let's open Microsoft Edge. Test out the keyboard. So I don't know if you noticed that, but typing was extremely responsive. And that's an extremely good sign, just because there are some Windows tablets that I've tried, not just Chinese ones, but even ones from Asus and Lenovo, where when you type really fast, it wouldn't register all the letters, right? So here, watch this. So I'm going to type in Google really fast. There you go, see? Registered all the letters over there. And sometimes it wouldn't register on other tablets, which is a really good sign for this tablet. So let's go to mobiletechasia.com. mobiletechasia.com. Okay. Let's scroll through and see what we have. Oh, showing you how to review. Let's see if you can see that properly. Yeah. Okay. So yeah, scrolling's smooth, but not exceptionally smooth. So excuse me, the performance, at least in Microsoft Edge, is just about average. It's not too responsive, but it's not laggy either. Let's try it with the mouse now. So the mouse feels perfectly fine. It's just a touchscreen, that's all. Touchscreen is a little, it's not super smooth, but not super laggy either. Let's see about zooming in. That's fine. Average. Okay. Now, let's go back home. So, I just want to show you this because it's a really good sign. Again, some Windows tablets that I've played around with, like Windows 10, when you hit the start button, see how this instantly goes to the start menu? There are some Windows tablets, again, not all Chinese, that when you hit this, there's like a delay of like half a second before you go to the start menu, which again is a great, it's a great sign for this tablet. So I'm extremely happy, very happy with the response of this tablet. Let's see. So let's go back home. So let's see, what else can I show you? Oh, there's a Microsoft Word here. This must be the mobile version of Microsoft Word, the free one at least. So let's go to blank document and let's type. Hello there. Can you see this? So yeah, typing's again really good. And I'm pretty sure this is the mobile version of Office just because you don't have all the functions. You have basic typing, which again is enough for me on a tablet like this. Review, view, blah, blah, blah. So all that is, it's all good. So yeah, actually, what I want to show you as well. Let's see, I want to go to Task Device Manager. And let's see if we can get some information on some of the stuff here. So we've got batteries, we've got disk drive. So this one has a Hynix eMMC. I'm not sure how fast that is. I'm gonna have to run some benchmarks on that. But yeah, so again, this is a super quick rundown of the Chuwi Hi10. Let's see what else I can show you. Maybe you want to show you the screen as well, see how good the screen is. So let's see, turn keyboard. Let's see, google.com. And let's look at wallpaper. Images. Let's go back to here. Okay. Yeah, I don't know if you can see this, but color is pretty good on the screen. Color's pretty good on the screen. The screen's definitely a lot better than the Chuwi Hi10 though. But yeah, so this is a really quick rundown of the Chuwi Hi10. I'm going to be posting my review video of the Chuwi Hi10 when I get my keyboard. And also, I'm going to be posting a comparison video between the Chuwi Hi10 and the Chuwi Hi10. So thank you so much for watching and have a great day. Please hit subscribe and hit any of the videos that should be popping up right about now.